Dowdy Brent dominance was not more than for a few years in the so-called D Company.
He's known for his path-breaking films and his bold and honest opinions on social media and in real life. And now, he's all set to bring his favorite genre to life again with his latest film, D Company. Welcome to Spot Boy Ram Gopal, sir. First of all, what is this film about? We know that it's about Dawood Ibrahim and his company, but what is it that you think is important for the audience to know before they start watching it?
See, that's a good question. See, when I made my past gangster films like Satya and Company, they were more or less like Satya was a fictional film set though in the real underworld, you know, but the characters were fictional and incidents were fictional. D Company was something where it took a small part of a feud between Rajan and Dawood at that time, and I tried to make a relationship film. Whereas D Company technically is like the not only the biopic of Dawood Ibrahim, but also it's a biopic of D Company. The difference is Dawood Ibrahim's predominance was not more than for a few years in the so-called D Company. Later, others took over the whole thing. It is just like a brand which they were using, where in most parts he was not really directly, interacting or active, I would say. So D Company overall is like the story of Mumbai underworld, like the Mahabharat of crime in a way, to say. In 1980, Dawood Ibrahim started in Dongri, and then I think it ends almost with Chota Rajan being arrested in Bali Island in 2015, which technically I would think is end of the underworld, you know, in a sense of the word. So D Company, the film, what we are putting out now is the first 2 years of Dawood Ibrahim's life when his brother was killed. And the first time, the event surrounding it, when Bombay people came to know the name of Dawood Ibrahim, that someone called Dawood Ibrahim exists. So I would say the origin in a certain way. So I think it's important because him being the most popular gangster ever will till today. We keep using the word D Company, and every once in a while we wake up and see how why we're not able to catch him and all that. So I think a man like that to actually make a street gang into international crime syndicate, I think it's important that we understand how something like that can happen on the other side of the law. I mean, it also would kind of expose the weakness in the establishment and policing systems and lots more things. So that is what, for me, my interest as far as this picture is concerned.
Okay. So you said that this is about the original story of Dawood Ibrahim. So is there a possibility of future of this film like a franchise? Because Dawood Ibrahim's story is a long one.
Yeah, it is. That is what I meant. It is like a series. It's like a multiple season thing which I'm making from 1980 to 2015. Okay. This particular film is only about the first 2 years. Rest of it will follow in a season.
Okay. So how long have you been working on this? Because I got to know that for 20 years you have been researching on this subject. So how has that process been for you?
I mean, I would say that it is not like, you know, I wasn't always conscious that I want to make this into a film, but the fact that when you're in Bombay, you keep on hearing stories. You keep on hearing when you sit with cops and you sit with some middlemen who probably are not exactly the underworld guys, but they know them. And you keep listening to anecdotes, you keep listening to various viewpoints and things. And slowly it starts forming in your mind in a certain way. That's what I've been doing. So I might be starting to know, but I think it took a form in my mind of how I want to make it, and probably a couple of years back. But then the pandemic slowed it down, and finally I managed to do it.
So you are streaming this film on a new OTT platform, Spark OTT. Why did you decide to go with a new platform instead of going with a known platform like Netflix or anything?
I mean, I think in today's timing and technology, I think I would like to have the maximum freedom without any loss in translation. Every platform will have its own policies and various other things, which I don't have the patience to go through that. Not that I don't want to do it, but especially with regard to D Company, I wanted the tremendous freedom how exactly you tell a story, and then you have a certain technology available, I thought it's best to make use of it.
Hmm. Okay. So, like, you are recreating a world of the 1980s, and you have made gangsters film before. So, these are very dark worlds, the dark environment that you show. So, does it ever take a toll on your own mind when you're showcasing such times, such environment?
Like, what kind of a tool? I'm not sure I understood.
As in, it take you to the deep end of me, or maybe mentally affect you in some way about that are happening?
I'm a storyteller, and anything, whether it's in real life or fictional, that story idea fascinates me.
Yeah.
And use the medium to the best of my ability to capture it cinematically is what keeps me high, and that's really my job. My passion.
Okay.
So I wouldn't say that it takes a toll on me.
Okay. So what is this fascination with the gangster or the action genre with you?
I mean, I wouldn't call it a gangster genre. I mean, there's something I've always done. I would like to believe that I like to study people who are extreme situations and the decisions they make them extreme people. It is something odd. It is something rebellious in nature.
Mm-hmm.
It is something... a kind of a situation, probably I would like to believe that they are as much victims as even the people they harm or kill sometimes.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So I think it is a study of very extreme people is how I would say it. It's not necessary that they're called, I mean, by labeling them as gangsters, I think it's too simplistic. Yeah.
Okay. So when it comes to an action genre film, there's kind of an appeal in the theaters, like when a hero comes, there's screaming, there's whistling, applause and all. And when a villain comes, there's booing or everything, that kind of an environment that settles. So do you feel like this film could have done, maybe have a better appeal if it had come in theater?
See, I do not believe there's a fundamental difference between a theater and OTT. The person is watching content, watching drama. In terms of right from the days of the video library, maybe 30 years back, people watched it in parallel at home. And over the last few years, maybe starting from 2015, if you take something like Narcos, for example, Netflix, I don't think anybody would really think that should come in a theater. You know, anything which holds up. Theaters, I think, are more for spectacle. I mean, like a Bahubali, for example, or a Fast and Furious, where there's tremendous CG work and huge, spectacularly mounted action sequences. You know? For that, I think theater. Otherwise, content-based, drama-based, and something which is dialogue-oriented. I feel the far better platform would be the OTT.
Okay. So, like in past, you have worked with many established actors, but currently you are kind of working with a very fresh cast, with a fresh team. So, how has the experience been different working with such fresh talent for you?
See, I've always worked with new people many times, right, from the start of my career. So the first, for example, after first film Shiva, I made Raat with completely new people, the horror film. And then Satya, of course, many times I did that. And I believe new cast will work, especially in genre films where the sense of realism, because established faces will always, with the baggage, make them like you watch them perform. Whereas new people, you take them as actual real actors. That's how I see it.
Okay. So, like, you are currently seeming like on a very professional role. You have just announced within the last 24 hours, I guess, two more films with Tablet and Dangerous. So, do you feel like you are...
Because all of them is made... Yeah. So, see, all the... These have been being nurtured ever since, not even being much before the pandemic also, because my intention was to start. And also, I wanted to do a lot of productions. We're taking new upcoming directors. Many of them have been done by others, not directly by me.
Okay. So, recently, Chota Rajan got hospitalized due to COVID. There were rumors about his death. Do you think that kind of increased the curiosity for your film, since he's in the news?
I honestly don't know if it's today's time people are aware of the underworld so much as maybe they once don't believe that is a requirement or such. For example, when Godfather was made in 1972, Mm-hmm. Actually, The Underground is pretty much finished by 1950s in America. Mm-hmm. That's where the story is based on 1930. I think they look at it like a story. At the end of the day, not really so much about the reality of the point.
Mm-hmm.
And like this, so gangster story, I think it's the drama which people get attracted to, not so much about who it's based upon.
Yeah. Okay.
So that is a starting reference point for the filmmaker, but I doubt the audience cares so much about that.
Mm-hmm. Okay. So recently when you tweeted about the danger, the announcement of Dangerous, there was a little backlash about the way you had formed the statement that due to their bad experiences with men, the girls turned to each other for love. So, what was the intention behind that statement, and do you think it was taken in a wrong way?
See, I mean, I think at least the point is I'm talking about the specific characters. Mm-hmm. I'm not making a general opinion on lesbians. Mm-hmm. I'm not doing that. I am just saying these particular two characters in the context of the story, both mm-hmm. of them have some bad experiences with men. And that kind of drives them towards each other. So that is not a generalized thing to be taken.
Okay. So you have been like very honest, very bold with your statements throughout your life. Do you think that kind of has isolated or maybe distanced you from the industry, within the industry, and kind of affected your professional relationships with people?
Mm. See, I mean, everyone has, I mean, the whole point of the social media is to express yourself. I mean, to state or to give an opinion or to express a feeling or whatever, that's what I do. And it might offend some people, it might, either which way, it doesn't make a difference to me.
Okay. So last year, there was an announcement about a film that was to be made on your life, a trilogy. So are you in touch with the makers about that, and what is the progress on that?
I mean, I'm not in touch with them because I'm not involved in any which way on a creative or any level with that. And also, the point is because the pandemic has put everything on hold, and no one really can plan anything because it's so uncertain in these times. So I think there's going to be pretty much delay, but I'm not really well aware of that.
Okay. So is there a phase of your life that you are really interested for the audience to see and see what you were going through during that phase?
I will say, I mean, not really particularly, because I'm too busy doing films and I don't have that much of time to think in those lines, actually.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah. So, what other films are you, films or shows or series that you are working on currently?
See, right now, my main concentration is on D Company season series. So, and actually, I'll be pretty much occupied with that for some time.
Okay. So, with D Company, Tablet, and Dangerous. These all are coming on Spark OTT, right?
Yes.
So, is this a collaboration with you, or you are involved in the platform on the creative side?
I mean, on the creative side, I am, but pretty much I'm a part of the whole platform.
Okay. But it was really interesting to talk to you, and we can't wait for D Company to release, because that is kind of a genre that you have excelled in, and that is a film that kind of goes with the audience who have kind of gone through that time. And it will excite the newer audience as well, that they will get to see something new that they don't know. So really congratulations to you for that, and really waiting.
Thank you.